Hola y bienvenidos. Yo soy señora Nelson y estoy aquí para ayudarles a aprender el español. We are here to master Spanish together. Now, like and subscribe and remember to tell me in the comments how your journeys are going. I want to hear all of the action steps that you've taken, all of the risks that you've taken, all the people that you've met and interacted with. How you've grown, how you've fallen, how you failed. Oof, I have plenty of stories of that as well that I'll have to save for another time because those are some of the best and most memorable moments and it's part of acquiring another language. I'm so proud of you. Keep it up. Today, I want to talk about the subjunctive tense. Now, when I taught Spanish, every time I talked about the subjunctive tense, I would offer a box of tissues for my students to cry. So if you have a box of tissues handy, feel free to use them. Feel free to cry because subjunctive is probably the most terrible part of learning the Spanish language for a non-native speaker. Today, I want to help you simplify it. Now, so in English, we have present, future, and past. In Spanish, we have present, future, past preterite, past imperfect, which we've talked about in a video, and take all of that and flip it to like the underworld, like in Stranger Things, there's a whole other world of verbs and it's called subjunctive. And when students find that out, they want to cry because, oh my word, I thought I learned everything and what is going on and I quit. Do not quit. Subjunctive is used all the time in English, but in Spanish, it is very intentional. Now listen carefully. Subjunctive is not a grammar tense per se. Subjunctive is an emotional tense. What do I mean by that? To simplify subjunctive to the most basic form, subjunctive is used whenever there is doubt. Whenever there is doubt, you will use subjunctive. Which is why when people have emotions, oh, I hope you have a good day, but what if you don't? Oh, may God bless, but what if he doesn't? That sounds bad, but, oh yeah, we'll leave as soon as he calls, but what if he doesn't? Anything that might not happen, I really advise that you guys study on this. But what if they don't? Anything that has doubt where the other person might not, you use subjunctive. So there's even tenses where you say, no, I'm sure this is right. If you say, oh, I'm not sure this is right, there's doubt, right? I do not doubt that you are telling me the truth. Check it again. I doubt that you're telling me the truth. Subjunctive. Anytime there's doubt, anytime something might not happen, may you get better soon. Also a bad one, but what if it doesn't happen? Anything that's not 100% positive fact gonna happen, has happened, you use subjunctive. And obviously you do even get into, well, we were hoping they were gonna open it, also subjunctive. But they ended up opening it at this hour, right? So subjunctive is used all the time in English. However, we don't have a different verb tense for it, which is kind of a fun, I personally enjoy it. If you're a native Spanish speaker, you don't even think twice about using it because it comes naturally, just like the English language would come naturally to an English native speaker. However, as a non-native of Spanish, I thoroughly enjoy subjunctive simply because to me, who has to think through the verb conjugations, it's a really fun extra neon light saying, this might not happen. This isn't guaranteed. Which for my crazy heart that imagines and tries to plan and tries to do all this stuff, it's kind of good for me to stay grounded, knowing this isn't reality yet. We're still in the subjunctive, excuse me, the subjunctive phase. It could be reality, but in this moment, it's not. Oh, I hope we get a snow day, but we don't know. Subjunctive is an emotion. If there is doubt, then you use it. It's a very simplified version. I know you can also use it of, oh, I'm so glad you're here. There's also times where emotions enter the picture and you'll also use subjunctive. But my personal rule of thumb has always been, okay, is this concrete? Is this 100% absolute truth? Or is there a possibility it won't happen? That's the subjunctive. Like and subscribe. Thanks for coming. If you're interested in continuing your education of acquiring the Spanish language, remember to go to elizabethteachesspanish.com. And I have some free PDFs where you can practice. Should I use the subjunctive? Should I not? It's completely free. Enter your email and I'll shoot a free PDF to you with the answers, just in case, where you can practice knowing if something is subjunctive or not. And of course, I will see you guys next week. Have a great day.